Talking about your dad, what are your dad's plans? Are you privy to those? I mean, I just wonder.
Actually, I don't know whether he will run for any positions at 2022. It's an option for him. Malakas pa naman siya, and he's very much active when it comes to public service. Kumbaga, parang ano na ata yan eh, nananalay time na dun sa dugo niya.
What about your brother? I ask because, you know, the Binay family is a dynasty, at least in Makati, no? So I'm just wondering what your political plans are.
Yeah, I think my brother is not running then for any position.
Oh, okay. So yung dad mo ang possible.
And I guess my sister will just run for re-election.
Yes. Okay. How do you feel as a Binay when people call your family a political dynasty? Does that hurt?
No. Kasi iba thinking ko dun sa yung the way we got this position, you know. I mean, at the end of the day, we went through a process. We got elected by the people, di ba? And ako, it was not easy for me. Nung 2013, nung tumakbo nga ako ng 2019, muntikan pa akong hindi makapasok, di ba? So, it's not a given na just because I'm a Binay, automatic mananalo ako for any position. I need to introduce myself to the people. I need to tell them what I can do. And at the end of the day, decision pa rin nila yun, di ba? So, hindi siya yung parang royalty na mamanahin mo yung titulo.
Yes, but at the same time, you do have to acknowledge that there is a great advantage to the incumbency. Like when a family has somebody, let's say in the past, as vice president, somebody in Congress, and then somebody running the city. And so that doesn't happen by accident, and that's not all ascribed to just, you know, we worked hard. I mean, not to take away from the hard work that you do put in, but not just speaking for yourself, but practically the majority of people in Congress, for example, the reality is it's a few families that keep changing hands. That's our definition of a dynasty. And we ask this siguro by way of, because we can't, it's very hard to ask somebody from Congress who is not part of a dynasty. Chances are we will have to ask somebody who is part of a political clan, who is entrenched as a political dynasty in their, I guess the question is, how do we get out of this cycle? Congress does not even want to fulfill its constitutional mandate to pass an anti-dynasty law.
Well, at the end of the day, baka it's about educating the voters na na meron pa silang pwedeng pagpilian. Kasi, babalikan ko lang. For example, sa Pasig, di ba, na natalo niya yung incumbent na mayor who's part of a political family. So it can happen. It's not, for me, it's not automatic eh. I guess we need to empower our voters na hindi rin naman porket yun yung titignan nila talaga yung quality ng kandidato beyond their last name.
So do you think this is something that does not really need legislating?
Kasi nandun sa constitution niya na
pero nothing's happening. Yes,
wala lang yung political will.
Yun lang yung nagiging problema. But, you know, at least dun sa SK, we were able to introduce parang may anti-dynasty. Yeah.
Meron. It's a start, yes.
I mean, it's a start. It's a start, diba?